Hello, namaste. Welcome to your healthy spine, healthy body yoga practice. I am so excited to do this class with you as the spine is so integral to keeping the shoulders, the hips, and everything that's attached functional and healthy. So when I work with my one-on-one clients, we always start by doing a few exercises on the spinal strip to get the spine nice and lengthened and the mobility going in the hips and the shoulders, so that when we go into more of like a flow, then the body is ready and prepared for that because the spine is all prepared for it. So, we are just going to do a quick spinal alignment practice with a spinal strip today. If you don't have a spinal strip, that's okay. You can take one of your blankets and fold it so it's nice and thin yet thick, so it would mimic the spinal strip. And then all we'll do is we'll just fold it in half. So whether you have the spinal strip or your blanket, you're going to take that long strip and fold it in half. Okay? The other thing that I'm going to talk about really quickly is I love essential oils. I love aromatherapy and all that they can do to support your body physically and emotionally. So as if you follow me on social media, you've seen me chat about this one quite a few times. It's one of my favorites. It's the Valor Oil. It is for courage, but it's also nicknamed Chiropractor in a Bottle because it helps support everything that we're doing on the spinal strip. So all I'm going to do with this is I'm going to take a couple drops, place it in my hand, it's this beautiful blue color, and I'm just going to place it along the length of my neck, give myself a little massage here, and then I'm going to rub some down on my low back and over my hips as well. A little bit goes a long way, all you need is one or two drops and you are ready to go. Now, if you want me to make any rollers for you, or if you want to get any oils from me, the links are below. So if you're wondering about that after doing this practice with me, go and check out the show notes below. Let's get into our yoga practice. So you're going to take that strip that you have, and you're going to start by going onto your side. So sliding into your fetal position, resting your arm on your head. Now I'll show you from behind. All I'm going to do once I'm in my fetal position is take my spinal strip and place it along the length of my spine so it's also supporting my head. And then all you'll do is roll onto it after that. And then just check that it's all lined up, your head is supported, and the spinal strip is in between your shoulder blades so that you can let your shoulders sort of relax down towards the earth. You can have your knees bent, soles of your feet on your yoga mat, or extend your legs out long in front of you, whichever feels more comfortable on your back. So some people start to feel a bit of like pinching happening or aching happening when they straighten their legs. That's just a signal from your body that it's going a bit too far and you need to re-bend your knees. So wherever is most comfortable for you. Now, once you've found that comfortable position, I want you to place your hands over top of your hips. Lengthen the back of your neck, so start to tilt your chin in towards your chest. Relax your shoulders down. Feel your glutes soften and take a nice deep breath in. Full breath out. Now, feeling where your hips are, you want to start to level them out so that they should be in one line and level on the mat beneath you. All right. From here, once you're all aligned and grounded, start to reach your fingertips up towards the ceiling. Hands are stacked over top of your shoulders, one long line from your fingertips down to your shoulders. Now I just want you to glide your shoulder blades up and away from one another so your hands start to reach towards the ceiling. And then glide your shoulder blades down towards your yoga mat. Lengthen up, lengthen down.
This should be one nice smooth movement up and down, shoulders moving in unison. So if you feel yourself go clunk, clunk, then you want to make that movement a little bit smaller so that your shoulders can move in one line together. All right, breathe with this. So as you breathe in, you're lifting your fingertips towards the ceiling. As you breathe out, you're gliding your shoulders down. Take five more deep breaths like this. Close your eyes. Just noticing how that feels in your shoulders, in your spine, shoulder blades. Amazing. Now lengthen your fingertips up towards the ceiling. And as you breathe out, you're going to glide your shoulder blades down and then cactus your arms to bring your elbows down onto your mat. So it almost looks like a football goalpost. Now reach back up, spread those shoulder blades away from one another. Breathe in. Breathe out, glide shoulder blades down, bring your elbows down to create that goalpost shape. Reach up, glide down. Three more. Really slow it down for this last one. Emptying out every last drop of air as you breathe out, slowly lowering those elbows down. Once your elbows are down, all you're going to do is do a rotation of your arm bone in your shoulder socket to rotate the backs of your hands towards the floor. And then imagine pushing the air forward. Okay, so you're rotating from the shoulder to bring backs of your hands down or as far down as they will go. And then visualize the air being super heavy to push it back towards the wall in front of you. Breathe in as the backs of your hands come down. Breathe out as you push the air forward. Three more. Slow it down. Amazing. Now bring the backs of your hands down, and I want you to send your fingertips towards the corners of the room to make a Y shape with your arms, and then glide your elbows towards your ribs to make a W shape with your arms. Breathe in as you create the Y shape. Breathe out as you create the W shape. Spreading your shoulders and your heart open as you breathe in. And gliding down that spinal strip as you breathe out. Two more. Beautiful. Hold the W shape. Let your shoulders relax down towards the earth. Close your eyes. Take five deep breaths. Beautiful. Slowly roll back onto your side for fetal position, using your right arm as a pillow for your head. Take that spinal strip out from behind you. Take a moment in your fetal position. This is our position of renewal, rebirth. Slowly roll back onto your back. Resting your arms by your sides, legs out in front of you. Just take a moment to notice how you're feeling now, opposed to when you started this practice. Amazing. Whenever you're ready, roll back onto your side. Gently press yourself up to seated.
From here, I encourage you to go on to do another yoga video. You could do one of mine that I have, or another one, or simply just turn on some music and do your own yoga practice. But now your spine is nice and aligned, everything is open. You found your mobility in your shoulders, which is correlated to what's going on into your hips as well. And I hope you have a beautiful rest of your day. Thank you so much for allowing me to take you through this important practice for your spine. All my love. Namaste. If you do want to work with me, I am taking a few online one-on-one clients right now, and I'd love to help you more with your spinal alignment and your yoga practice in general. Also, if you want to work with me with aromatherapy, I would love to help you with that as well. That's one of my passions, and I have my links below, as mentioned before, on how you can get those oils from me or if you want me to make anything for you. A beautiful rest of your day. Bye.